don't you think about the most discouraging event that took place in your life? It could be you were expecting to marry a girl or a guy. Everything was going good. Boom! One day you get that text message saying, I don't think this is going to work out. And she breaks up with you. He breaks with you. You're like, wait a minute. What are you talking about? We just had a great date last week. We just talked about life together 10, 20, 30 years from now. Very confused. Maybe you're working for a boss of yours and he tells you if you do X, Y, Z, you hit these numbers, you're going to get a promotion. You hit all those numbers. And it comes time for a promotion. He gives a promotion to Johnny, not to you. You're discouraged. Maybe it's you got great ideas, but no one's listening to you. Maybe you're sitting there saying, man, I've been financially in the same exact situation for 2-3 years. What the hell do I need to do? It's discouraging, right? I will tell you from personal experience, the most discouraging times were when you're putting effort and you're not seeing progress or results. This can psychologically mess with you to not believe that enough effort is going to produce progress. And for the rest of your life, you're just going to be like, well, even if I give my best, nothing's going to happen. Even if I love this person, nothing's going to happen. Even if I give my best here savings, nothing's going to happen. So for this to work for my head, my brain, I had to come up with levels for me to understand and manage expectation and a level of patience I need to have. And I created 7 timelines for myself. Here's what the timelines are. In order to see any glimpses of change, it takes about 21 days, right? The second one is 90 days. Anything that I did to my business, a new idea I implemented, I said, here's what we're going to start doing every week on the such and such day. And I'm like, okay, first week, no results. Second week, no results. Third week, no results. Fourth week, no results. Fifth week, a little bit of results. Sixth week, a little bit of results. Seventh week, a little bit of results. It's not really working. Let me drop it. 90 days. That's only 7 weeks, 8 weeks, 9 weeks, 10, 11, 12, 13th week. Bam. Oh, this works. I'm glad I stuck with it for 90 days. So far we have what? 21 days, 90 days. Then it's 12 months. Then it's 36 months. Then it's 5 years, 10 years, 20 years. Here's how you got to look at it. So again, 21, 90, 12 months, 3 years, 5 years, 10 years, 20 years. The bigger the change you want to make, the longer it takes. Okay. So if your change is a generational type of a change with a mindset and the way of thinking, your family's been known as the poor, broke family, you want to make a real massive change, it's probably going to take 10 to 20 years. Maybe your generation is full of entitled complainers. You're like, I'm sick and tired of me being linked to my generation and being complainers. I want to do something about it. Maybe you're going to be able to make a change, but maybe it's a 10 to 20 year type of a change. But your body, you want to make some kind of a change, maybe 21 or 90 days. So what happens now if you're saying, well, Pat, I want to make some major changes in my life. I want to do something big. Great. Then that major change is going to require you longer term. But here's the other part. So far you got the timeline to manage expectations so you don't get discouraged, right? Now here's the other part. This doesn't mean 21 days later or 90 days later, you're going to automatically see results. No. Your level of urgency and effort will dictate the level of changes you'll see. So urgency, effort, and patience. 21 days, some people will say, I'll be patient for 21 days, but I don't know about 90 days. Well, that's your problem. I'll be patient for 90 days. I'll give this real estate thing a shot for 90 days, but I don't know about a year, Pat. I don't think I'm going to do that. Well, that's your problem. Well, I'll give this thing a shot here. I see things going with this company, and I think it's going to work. I'll give it 1 year, but I don't know about 3 years. Well, then that's your problem. Well, I'll give this thing 3 years, but you know, 3 years, I swear if I don't get to this, well, then it's my 5 year. I'm not giving it 5 years. Everything is about patience, urgency, effort. One of those three is lacking. If one of those three lacks, you're not going to see changes. If you're not patient, you're definitely not going to witness the change. So I started investing money when I was in the Army. One of my buddies is like, Pat, start putting aside 25 bucks a week. I said, what the hell is 25 bucks a week? He says, it's 25 bucks a week. Just start doing it. I said, I'm not doing it. So he starts putting $25 a week. Year goes by, 2 years goes by, 3 years, Army's done with. He went from 25 a week to 50 a week to 75 a week to like 100 a week, right? 3 years later, he shows me his account. He says, here's how much money I got. Shows me his account. He's got like $15,000, $18,000. I said, you got $18,000? You guys got to realize $18,000 is a lot of money at 21 years old. He said, how much you have in your account? I said, dude, what are you talking about? What, the last 2 bottles of tequila, that's how much money I had. That's my savings account, what I had. I had nothing when I got out of the Army. Literally zero. 3 years later, he had $15,000. I said, listen, patience, effort, urgency equals results. So in one of these areas, I wasn't patient. All I thought about is 25 bucks a week. What the hell is 25 bucks a week? 25 bucks a week increasing 3 years later is $15,000, $18,000. Guy buys a Mickey Mantle rookie card in 1998 for $104,000. They said, this guy lost his mind. He's the owner of the Arizona Diamondbacks. He buys it for $104,000. people said, you paid $104,000 for Mickey Mantle PSA 10 rookie card? Yes. You know what that card is worth today? $18 million. He kept it for 23 years. 23 years, the card went from $100,000 to $18 million. Patience, he had the effort to have the money to buy it, and he put the effort into it, right? So again, you either have a patient issue, you have an effort issue, or you have an urgency issue. Your urgency issues, I'll do it tomorrow, I'll do it next week, I'll start next month. That's not gonna happen. Then you don't have the formula in place. You either don't put the real effort in or you don't have the patience. But if you got all three, and you know the seven timelines, 21, 90, 1, 3, 5, 10, 20, you're gonna be all right long term. So having said that, if you got value from this message here, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. If you've not seen the video, I got a video I wanna recommend to you. It's 12 mistakes I made my first year as an entrepreneur. If you've never seen that before, click over here to watch it. Take care, everybody. Bye-bye.